Settled across from the gargantuan Namba station in downtown Osaka, this small branch of Super Potato gets overshadowed by the much larger RetroCon just a few minutes walk down the street. The Namba location of the famous retro game chain is more emblematic of Super Potato's roots, a game store that encompasses all eras, not just the very old. Its first floor looks like every other game shop, crowded with new releases and some overpriced VR units. You'll see a horde of Kirby's Air Ride, which someone decided was worth upwards of $70. They also have the latest in retro, like a European NES Classic Edition for $300. For Super Potato, this modern floor stretches back to the PS1, so you'll have to walk upstairs to the retro floor to find a stash of treasure, at prices I wouldn't necessarily pay. It's still fun to look around, though I would caution against buying anything without shopping around. So let's see what they got. Michael Jackson is moonwalking himself onto the Mega Drive for $60. To the side, I found the shooter V5 pushing near $180. Japanese Mega Drive games really have skyrocketed in value the last few years. I vowed to get every Contra game I can, but $450 for Contra Hardcore is just too much. Bringing us back down to Earth is a boatload of Gunstar Heroes selling at $50 apiece, and the Sonics 1 through 3. Pocky and Rocky are a couple of expensive Super Nintendo games, and their Super Famicom counterparts are going for $100 apiece. Their American versions can easily double that. The beat-em-up Iron Commando is one of the rarest games for the Super Famicom, so it's sitting pretty at almost 250 big ones. For just a little less, you could get a special Hello Kitty Edition Dreamcast. Pair that with a non-Hello Kitty arcade stick for $35. This end of the showcase has the most valuable games for the Famicom. The Shmup Recca will blast your wallet for $500 for the cart alone. Gimmick for $650, and the Famicom version of Super Spy Hunter. The American version auctions for about $20, but this Japanese localization is almost $300 for the bare cart. I have to accept that I'll never find a cheap Metal Slug. The Neo Geo CD release is worth $270, but I could buy the amazing shooter Sonic Wings 2 for $20 plus tax. Of course, it would be Neo Geo games that are the most expensive games in the store. Despite some light manual scuffs, Ninja Masters is priced at a cool $2,000. If you want a cheap Neo Geo game, you'll have to settle for Samurai Spirits at $40. Someday, my N64 collection will be worth something, just not today, since the relatively rare Resident Evil 2 and Evangelion carts are going for $30. The incredible Bangayo, however, is going for $150 CIB. 64DD games, on the other hand, are worth the prettiest of pennies. This sealed copy of Japan Pro Golf Tour 64 can be yours for about $750. Sometimes American consoles and games will be up for sale. They've priced an American N64 at almost $100. Right underneath it is a Japanese Toys R Us exclusive controller for $300. And if you're interested, it is region-free. Game Boy stuff is getting expensive too, and I should have seen it coming. A CIB system is $120, and complete copies of Pokemon are $50. A few years ago, I paid $20 at this very same location, and even then it was a ripoff. Super Potato's Sega Saturn selection and prices are actually pretty decent. Here we've got Mega Man X4 at $45, and Sexy Parodius for about the same price. The rare shooter Hyper Duel is almost $300. Battle Garega can go for $200 elsewhere, but here it's $120, which is a steal for one of the greatest shooters ever made. Now back to the complaining. You could buy the Famicom versions of Donkey Kong or Kirby for $15, but they'll go for half that at other stores. The first Super Mario Bros. Is a crime at $70, and number 3 should be $30 less. The prices on Double Dragon 2 and 3 are fair, although you should never buy Double Dragon 3, ever. So spend your money on a CIB Double Dragon 2 for about $100. The Neo Geo Double Dragon, on the other hand, is $600. Sometimes the price difference between a loose cart and a CIB copy can be just $10. Or in Mega Man's case, the cart is $50 and the box is $450. An American Chippendale 2 cart goes for $200 easy. Or you could get this Famicom copy for $55. Likewise, this Gunak is $45, significantly less than the American localization. Castlevania games are rare enough, and when you do find one, prepare to pay. Vampire Killer or Castlevania Bloodlines is reaching $600 for a CIB copy. The stacks on stacks of games can be intimidating, but the displays do have some kind of method to them. Here's a row of shooters and a row of Disney Super Famicom games. $100 will get you that Super Famicom, an additional $40 will get you the carrying case. Now I can finally act out my Napoleonic fantasies for just 8 bucks. $8. So I've complained a lot. The prices of Japanese games are going up every year, and Super Potato's prices have gone up more than most everywhere else. Yet every time I'm in Osaka, I still visit both downtown locations. The prices aren't always bad, so with a little knowledge, you can keep yourself from getting burned. As always, the thing you want is always cheaper somewhere else. Thanks for watching, and mahalo.